Hello Gundam fans, this is Prime92, and today I'll be doing the unboxing and review of the Gundam Hellokitty Haropla, and I got the model kit from Canadian Gundam. Link is in the description below. So it's an anniversary model, because they did a little collaboration with Gundam and Hello Kitty. There was a couple OVA shorts, which was a little disturbing, actually. And I got this. And I don't have a lot of Haro, so I figured, why not? It is different, because it is Hello... I don't have anything Hello Kitty now that I think about it. This is the first. And I do like the fact that the plates are colored. So I was initially thinking it'd be a lot of stickers, but actually no. And then we got the two plates that are new for the kit. And the stickers, like I said, not really that much. So that's cool. Now, interesting enough, this is just an assembly sheet, just telling you basically how to cut parts off a plate, even though it says on the box here, no nippers required, but the instructions are on the inside. So they decided to forego the instructions, I've been with other ones, and you just use the box, which is fine. I mean, it's not that hard to do. And that being said, let's build the kit. And here's the Hello Kitty Haropla all put together on his little puzzle stand. Definitely looking like a Hello Kitty ball. Now, without all the stickers, you basically just have the eyes and the ears with the bow. So, you got like a cat-ish white and blue Haro. And, definitely need the stickers to make it look like really good. And it does. It looks very Hello Kitty-ish. Just, you know, you got the whiskers, the nose, looks like the overalls there. Kind of Mario. They could definitely do a Mario one if they wanted. Just have, like, the hat on paint on one of the sides here. It'd just be red overalls there, and yeah, that could work. They could do that. Now you saw all the parts left over are under here. And you do have other stickers to go around the arms to make it look like the top as well. Of course, you can plug that hole with the blue piece, which is there. Very hard to get out, I have to say, once you have it in there. But you do have the panels here, which you have to kind of push in, I find, right here. So you can get your fingernail in to get those out. So then you can take the ones that are in here without the hands. And shove them in the holes. Which do have some nice detail in there. It is black, so it's a little hard to see. And so now its legs are ball jointed. And then you can lift up the ear panels and take the hands, which are also ball jointed, and they can also go in because of how they're cut. And just stick it into that ear hole. And then I like to have them curved down so that you can kind of get the ears closer down to the head. I guess it is. And of course you can open it up. It does have a double hinge, so you can show the keyboard that's on the inside. You can kind of get it back a little bit like that. That's definitely kind of creepy looking. And I'll probably just keep it displayed like that. It could also be like a Where's Waldo, now that I look at it. Just needs a toque to pick onto the side. And in case you're wondering how big these Haropla kits are, well, there's an entry grade, RX-MVA2. They're pretty small. There's the bigger version. I'm surprised they didn't do... do they do both versions, the bigger one and this one? I don't know. I know there's SDs that you can get with the Hello Kitty head, which I kind of want to get, but they're kind of pricey. This guy was cheap. Just to have something for the collaboration is cool, I think. So if they still have them, click the link below to go to Canadian Gundam, and I'll see you in the next review.